Yeah. They don't know how he did it. Sway in the Morning, Shade 4-5. Lewis Carr is here. Let me read something about you, man. Hold up. I like to read about you. I'm going to read what's written so folks will know. Lewis Carr established the Dirty Little Secrets Men Only Edition Conference to bring together top thought leaders in the country within their respective fields. The mission of the conference is to provide men with a powerful forum to enhance leadership skills, find clarity for their mission and goals, as well as provide tools to achieve new levels of personal and professional success.
Love it.
This DLS conference for men features interactive panel discussions, high-level networking, and keynote speeches. Lewis Carr, president of media sales at BET Networks, has generated $7 billion in revenue over his 31-year career.
Woo!
Enough said.
Yes.
You want to know who to listen to? You should listen to Lewis Carr. You got questions? Ask Lewis Carr. You want to get involved? You want to elevate your life? You want to change your community? You want to grab hold of things that are happening right now? Come to this convention, this conference, Men's Only Edition Conference. Register at dlsmen.com. How do we address the youth? It's difficult. I remember being a teenage and adults who I thought a 29-year-old was, you know, old adult. You know what I mean? A 30-year-old trying to say, hey, man. I had a man once tell me when I first started making money, it flew over my head. He said, look, take that $10K that you saved, put it in this account here. Don't touch it. Let it mature. Wait 15, 20 years. That $10K may be 50. Put it away. That $10K may be 100, depending on the kind of it. It flew over my head. I didn't learn about finances until I got in trouble with the IRS early in my career, and I owed maybe $8,000, and I thought it was the end of the world. And I had an accountant sit down with me and from point A to point Z teach me about taxes and how to save and how to budget. We don't have that. I feel like financial literacy is something that really needs to start being taught at an early age in elementary, because we have the ability to make a lot of money. We have the freedom to spend a lot of money, but we're always behind.
Right.
Is that, will that be discussed?
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
So on Saturday, we're doing something called Hope Luncheon. So remember, this conference is taking place in Chicago.
Yeah.
Probably the most violent city in the country right now. Mm-hmm. So I wanted to make sure that we wanted to be inclusive of our young people. So we're bringing together 100 high school males to really share this experience, share knowledge. So the thought leaders can really sort of touch them, mm-hmm. engage with them over a 2-hour period on Saturday afternoon.
Mm-hmm.
So we're bussing these kids in from all over the city so they can sort of at an early age get some influence, understand what these people have been through. Because just about everybody that's coming has a story
where
they were down
mm-hmm.
and now they're up.
And now they're up, yeah. The top is much better than the bottom. Go ahead, Mike. I'm on my own with that. That's a Jay-Z lyric, right?
No. We got your back, brother.
Okay.
We got your back.
Don't, man. Come to the conference. Get my back at the conference.
Lewis Carr, man, congratulations on the conference, man. I'm really excited for that you're having this conversation. What I love about what you're doing is that for far too often, black men are seen as very monolithic groupings of individuals. And what I'm excited for is this diverse set of individuals that you have there. Why was that important to you to select a wide range of individuals from different backgrounds, from different walks of life to really tackle these subject matters that you're approaching?
To give people possibilities, no matter where they are in their life, that they can do anything that they want to do. If they are really committed to reinvention, if they are committed to change, and they're committed to work hard. So I wanted people to see how many paths that there are to success.
Many paths to success. It's not only just one way. You ain't got to just sell drugs.
Yes.
And then learn how to clean the money. And now you're a success. Now there's other ways to get there, right?
Clearly.
But even with that Sway and Lewis Carr, that we always think about it as one way. We think that you're either the athlete or the entertainer, or we think that you're just this finance guy, right? But you have fashion here. You have a guy who used to be acting CEO of an airline company that is here. You have a DJ. So there's so many facets of black men and black culture, and I'm really thankful for somebody like you to highlight that aspect of it. There's many pathways to success.
Right. So you've got got entertainment, you've got business, you've got money, you've got fashion, just about every sort of field you can think of, we have a thought leader, somebody who's at the top of their game to come in. I mean, we've got Ron Williams, who used to be the former chairman of Aetna Insurance Company, who is a Chicagoan.
Wow.
All right. And he's going to explain Obamacare to us.
Oh, that's dope.
I mean, because how many people have it?
Yeah.
And don't know what it really is.
Yeah. Or don't have it.
Or don't have it.
Yeah. Yeah. I just want to talk, because you talked about like the path to success and all these different angles and how to get there. And you brought up fashion, and there's been a lot of debate about, you know, like kids sagging pants and things like that, and you should dress for success. At what point do you feel like somebody should dress for the part or for whatever, you know, job that they're going for versus they're just a kid and, you know, let them get it out of their system, or you know what I mean? Like, from boy to man.
Well, as we all know, fashion has many aspects. And one of the things that I do with my foundation, when kids come in, whether they have earrings or whether they want to dress, you know, with baggy pants, in the office, there's a dress code. Mm. Mm. So you have to be flexible in your life and be able to change based on the situation and the environment that you're in. So that's one of the things that we teach consistently. So, you know, I got a tie on the day. Mm-hmm. I might not have that on the night. Well, matter of fact, I know where I'm going. I won't have it on the night.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So where are you going? What strip club are you going to?
Yeah,
I want to go. Come on, man. Let's fraternize, brother.
Louis, would you consider maybe for a future conference with ever having a female speaker? And the reason why I ask that is I'm not going to make this a blanket statement, but I'll notice a lot of men don't necessarily want to learn from women. Mm-hmm. And I realize a lot of men will enter a more like female dominated space and have no problem like sharing the wealth and telling us, hey, you should do this, maybe try that. But I never really see like women in male dominated space just speaking to a crowd of men.
I'm not going to say never.
Yeah.
But what I will say is that the reason this is men only, I wanted to create a safe environment where men can be vulnerable. They can share some of the things that they don't know and feel safe doing it. So that's why it's sort of a male only environment.
Got you.
All right. Hi. We got Jay on the line from Maryland. If you want to talk with Lewis Carr, find out more about this, 888-742-3345. Jay, what up?
Yo, Jay.
Yo, what's going on, man?
What's happening, man? What's your question? Go ahead, Jay. Give me some energy, right. Jay. You in the office now. Put your tie on, baby. You ready?
Oh, it's all good, man. I really got a question and a comment.
Okay.
My question is for Mr. Carr. My comment is really towards you, Shway. But my question is how detailed that the conference will be for everybody to understand what it is they would need in every way possible to keep focused and become more successful in their life and things. Because there are some conferences that's good, but they're never that much detail with everything that's going on with their conferences.
So we're going to have keynote addresses. We're going to have fireside chats, and we're going to have panels. Some of the things the panels will deal with is navigating corporate America, relationship panel, the good, the bad, and ugly. Everybody can relate to that in some form or fashion. We're also going to have people talk about health, you know, black men's health.
Mm-hmm.
How do we improve our health? You know, what's the right weight size? You know, how often should you go to the doctor? How often should you get checkups? We're also going to talk about, you know, how to start a business, how to sustain a business. Everybody wants, you know, man, even in your corporate America, you got a side hustle. All right.
Yeah, true.
So, you know, how do you start that business and maintain that business over a long period of time? Damon Johns is going to talk about business in general, how to start a business. You know, what do you need in the beginning and how to sort of keep that going? So we're going to get very detailed over the course of 2 days.
Awesome.
Jay, what's your comment for me?
My comment basically was just what you were saying as far as like getting towards the youth. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's not impossible. It's the thing that I feel like honestly is really missing, and not to really go against the grain with what you were saying, is just that consistency is what's needed. You feel what I'm saying with the youth. And it doesn't matter what you're trying to teach them. To be honest, like Tupac Shakur said this a long time ago in an interview, and I watched this, and he said straight up, don't get mad at the pimps and the hustlers for teaching kids, because other people in certain positions won't teach them anything. They'll just tell them certain things, but a hustler will be consistent. with doing that versus like some people that'll just sit up there and hear you and talk about it. And like I had a guy I knew, he had a landscaping company. He only wanted to hire young guys. And he gave up after a couple of weeks because some of the kids would slack off. And I said, man, listen, you can't do that. You have to be consistent. You have to stay on that. Mm-hmm. Because a lot of times, which is true, we don't have, as young black men, we don't have, you know, people, especially that, you know, that hard father or, you know, a figure to keep us on our P's and Q's, you know, mm-hmm. that's staying consistent. So, you know what I'm saying? In any way, shape, form, or fashion, consistency is what's missing, period.
Jay, Jay, thank you for that information, Jay. That's what this is all about, Jay. Thank you, man. We're going to educate each other, man. I hope you can make it. Are we streaming the conference? Is it going to be streamed?
It is not going to be streamed.
Okay, yeah. So, but afterwards, I'm sure there'll be footage that people will that's be able correct. To go online and find it, all right? Jay, if you
can. Appreciate y'all. Thank you.
Nah, you're a thanks, citizen, Jay. Man, and we'll be there representing for you, okay? I'm going to take another call. This is for you, Lewis Carr. This is Roger in D.C.
Hey, Roger.
Go ahead, Roger.
Hey, what's up, Lewis, man? This is, man, I'm calling because, I've been in the game, man, for a long time, man. And you know, I've been saving up some money. You know, I got $10,000 myself, you know what I'm saying? I'm trying to figure out what to do with it, man. It can't just be sitting over here in my closet, you know what I mean? And you know, I don't know if I can, you know, use the whole bank route like you're saying at the moment or something, you know? But I've been thinking about investing or putting it in something. I just don't know what, you know? And ain't nobody around me can tell me anything about, you know, nothing like that. You know, everybody's just going to say, well, keep doing what you got to do, man. You know, keep putting it away, you know? But
I like
that. Well, Roger, I can tell you this. On October 13th and 14th, there will be so many people in that room that can advise you on what to do with that $10,000. So I've got CEOs of banks that, mm-hmm. that are going to be there. We got Damon Johns that are going to be there. We got Chris Gardner that's going to be there. Mm-hmm. All of those people can tell you what's the best opportunities because there's no one. There are many opportunities that you can choose from to sort of invest that money.
So here's my first, and if I would suggest that you go to dlsmen.com, Roger. You still there?
Yeah, I'm still in my head.
Okay, so go online. Kelly, give me a site that he could find the cheapest plane tickets.
Orbitz.
Go to Orbitz online. Get you a cheap round trip ticket. Find a cheap hotel room. You ain't going to spend more than a G to get out there. That's your first investment is in yourself.
Yes.
Okay? Yep. So make that first investment in you. Come to the conference. You'll probably see me there. I'm the easiest person to approach. Go to these panel discussions. Take notes. Pull out your phone. Take notes in your phone. If you want to take a pen and a pad, I'm old school. I do that. Take notes there. Come and learn, man. Because what it sounds like is you're trying to change, you know, you're trying to grow and evolve your situation. And the first investment, I had a friend who had 1 foot in the streets and he had 1 foot in a dream, you know, to go into the culinary industry. And we sat and talked and I told him, man, you can't be half in and half out. You got to take the full dive. And that full dive is just saying you got 100% faith in your capability. Let the other stuff go. He let the other stuff go, man. This man gets 6 figures contracts right now for his passion, you know.
And you know, so, man. You know, it's hard, though, Sway, man. You know, everybody say, go do this, go do that, man. And, you know, they want you to compromise yourself to get some of this money, man. You know, I want to wear dreadlocks. You mm-hmm. know what I'm saying? Keep them neat or whatever. You know, go on these interviews with these folks, man. And, you know, they look at you, you know what I'm saying? And you know, you don't get what you need to get, man. You got to do what you got to do, man. Time move every day, you know. Well, ain't nobody waiting. You know, the kids ain't waiting for no, you know, they ain't waiting for for no job interview, for no, you know, for their meals, you know what I'm saying? So it's hard, man. But I'm trying to, you know what I'm saying? I'm
trying to change it up. Hey, man, Roger, I'm with you. You know, but if you, what's the definition of insanity?
Doing the same thing over and over
and looking, expect different results.
You're not going to get any different results, Roger, unless you change up something you're doing. And it sounds like you're trying to grow and elevate. Come to the conference.
Yes. Look forward to seeing you, Roger.
All right, Roger, you're a citizen, brother.
A Sway in the morning, do
all
that.
All right, my man, Roger, man. I like Roger.
Yeah.
I like you, Lewis.
Me too.
I like saying I know you. I say your name just in random conversations at cocktail parties.
People salute you.
I have my man Lewis Carr on the show. Oh, you know Lewis Carr?
Cocktail party. fuck.
Congratulations. This is so necessary. I'm glad to be a part of it.
Thank you so much.
Absolutely.
And DLSmen.com.
That's what's up. DLSmen. Yes. Can we get some t-shirts or something, DLS right. men?
But remember, get your ticket.
Oh, there will be some there.
Okay, good.
Just to be clear, guys, make sure that you get your ticket. You can't just roll through, knock, knock. Can I have a space, a seat? No, get your ticket. Right, Lewis?
Yes.
And I guarantee you that and you'll be around some of the most successful people that, you know, the business has ever seen, you know, and because they're there means that they're open to communicate with you. So you'll be able to shake a lot of hands and don't hound dudes, you know, they're going to try to get to as many people as possible.
Right.
You know, get your 2-minute game up, practice your 2-minute game. What can I learn in 2 minutes from this man? And allow them to keep spreading energy and spreading truth, man. But you know,
and Sway, let's do something, because you're my man and you've been supportive.
Yeah,
let's give your listeners a special code to get $50 off.
Okay.
DLS Citizen.
Mm-hmm.
DLS Citizen. So when they get to the site, they put in DLS Citizen, they'll get $50 off.
Okay,
that's
so
a big deal.
Go to DLSmen.com, put in a special code, DLS Citizen. Citizens. And get that money off, all right? Use that $50 for lunch with me, all right? Lewis Carr, thank you for coming through, brother.
Thank you.
Always good. We got Celebrity Wire up next.
Yeah, someone's telling stories about Donald Trump's past.
Shade 45. It's Sway in the morning, only on Shade 45.